Hi friends, here in this video I'll be explaining how to measure the minor diameter of a screw thread. So let's get started. The measurement of minor diameter. Now what is the minor diameter? In case of screw threads, there are two different diameters. Now the diameter which I am showing here, it is called as the minor diameter, also called as the root diameter. And it is denoted by D suffix C, the core diameter, also called as root diameter, also called as minor diameter. Similarly, we have the outer diameter as well, which is called as the nominal diameter. So here in this video, specifically we are going to see how to measure this core diameter or the root of a screw thread. For that, what we have to do is we have to take an anvil of a special shape, like we can see here. This is the micrometer anvil, having pointed ends. So pointed ends of the anvil are to be used when we are measuring the core diameter, because if we are measuring the outer diameter, in that case the anvil would be flat, cylindrical, the pointed edges won't be there. So since we have to measure the core diameter, we have to use the anvil with pointed edges. And this screw thread would be held between two centers of the floating carriage micrometer. And how the arrangement is done, that is how we are keeping the screw in the floating carriage micrometer, for that you all can refer my video, whose link would be provided in the description below. So you all can just check it out, how to measure the screw thread or adjust it in a floating carriage micrometer. Now the screw thread would be held between two centers on the floating carriage micrometer, and from the opposite ends there would be pointed anvils in contact with the core diameter. And at first what we are going to do is we are going to keep a master cylinder. This master cylinder is a standard piece having diameter D1, which would be known to us before, and this diameter D1 would be very much close to the diameter which we want to measure, that is D suffix C. So D1 would be adjusted in the micrometer anvil and the floating carriage micrometer. Now we have to take the reading in the micrometer. That reading would be indicated as R1. So at first D1 is known to us because it is a standard master cylinder. R1 is the reading of the master cylinder which we are getting. There would be slight difference between this D1 and R1 value, because D1 is the original diameter and R1 is that which we are taking by fitting it onto the floating carriage micrometer. So some errors may come out. So D1 and R1, there may be some slight change in the values. So R1 is the reading of the master cylinder we are getting in the floating carriage micrometer. Next, once the setting has been done, because master cylinder is used in order to set the distances between the anvil, so now the master cylinder would be replaced. In place of that, the screw thread would be placed, as we can see from this diagram. Now the screw thread is placed, and if it is not fitting in this core diameter, we have to make slight adjustment, because there may be differences between the master cylinder diameter and the core diameter which we want to measure. So again we are going to get another set of reading, and that reading is denoted as R2 on the floating carriage micrometer. So initially D1 is the diameter of master cylinder. Its reading is taken on the floating carriage. The value is indicated by R1. Master cylinder replaced. In place of that, there is screw thread. Anvils are in contact with DC. We are going to get the reading as R2. Now, by using a simple formula, that is core diameter D suffix C or the minor diameter, the formula is D1 plus or minus R2, that is the second reading, minus the first reading. This is the formula with the help of which DC or the core diameter can be calculated, and the diameter would be in terms of mm. And as we have seen, there are lots of setting, or we can say the adjustment is required in order to measure this minor diameter with the help of the floating carriage micrometer. So this process takes a lot of time. At the same time, it would require a skilled operator so that we can take the accurate reading. So in short, that was a video regarding the measurement of minor diameter. At the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you'll get like, share, comment and subscribe our channel and share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.